touched me.
Oh, he touched me. And oh, the joy that floods my soul. Something happened, and now I know he touched me and led me.
There are many people who are beyond your city. Kujawa na roho
has given us power and authority to resist.
Not everybody who prophesies is a good prophet.
And the gospel is very simple. The gospel is all about what Jesus said and what Jesus did. God will never allow the devil to come and tempt you in levels that are higher than your faith.
Our theme is effectively use your authority. I think it is there. Possessing what is rightfully yours. Part 3. Theme: effectively use your authority. Scripture is 7:1-3, Deuteronomy. Please let's go together in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 7. Okay, give us the verses. When the Lord your God brings you into the land which you go to possess, and has cast out many nations before you, the Hittites and the Gergesites and the Amorites and the Canaanites and the Perizzites and the Hivites and the Jebusites, seven nations greater and mightier than you. Verse 2. And when the Lord God, your God, delivers them over to you, you shall conquer them and utterly destroy them. You shall make no covenant with them, nor show mercy to them. Verse 3. Nor shall you make marriages with them. You shall not give your daughter to their son, nor take their daughter for your son. Father, in the name of Jesus, I want to thank you and I want to bless your holy name. Because great is your faithfulness, and that we thank you for the gift of life this morning. And we bless you, dear Lord, for giving us another opportunity even to live for the glory of your name. We give all the glory, honor to you for all that you have done unto us and that you are purposing to do to us. Bless you and exalt your name as you bless us here and on the media, on the Facebook, on the YouTube. Lord, I pray that you shall bless us all together. Thank you, dear Lord, as I stand before your people. May I be, dear Lord, find favor before you, because I'm not the best, but you have chosen me just to be a servant this morning. Be blessed and be exalted. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. So as we continue with our subject, we must be willing and purposing to possess, because to possess is also a occupy. I said there is a trinity about possessing: is possessing, inheriting, and inhabiting, so that you can have it fully yours, that you may possess all that which is rightfully yours, that which the Bible calls yours. You should possess it and have it with you. Therefore, to possess, you may not be stronger than the one who holds your possession.
or who occupies your possession. But while you are with God, because our weapons of warfare are not carnal, but spiritual, praise the name of the Lord, pulling down the strongholds, powers, and forces of darkness, that we may access to what is rightfully ours. Our fathers, they were using physical strength, physical power, but us, in the dispensation of Jesus Christ, we are using the power of God and the power of the Word of God, praise the name of the Lord, to possess all that is rightfully ours. I want to remind you, what is rightfully ours is what I don't have and I'm supposed to have it. That is what we call rightfully ours. It is supposed to be mine, but as yet I have not gotten it. Then I have to go for it. Praise the name of the Lord. I say praise the name of the Lord. Some of the things that you don't have, they are in possession of somebody who is not worthy to be possessing. Here the Bible talks about seven nations which were very small, but put together, seven of them, they were greater than Israel. But now, as greater in numerical point of view, and we feel with God, therefore their numerical bigness is just nothing before few of us with God. Praise the name of the Lord. I say praise the name of the Lord. Sometimes we look at ourselves and we demean ourselves by saying, I can't, I am poor, I am jobless, I am not educated, I am young. And all these excuses are not valid, because God does not go with those. He goes with what is rightfully yours. The land that they are going to occupy, the land that they are going to possess, was it empty? I'm asking you, was it empty? It wasn't empty. It was occupied, but with the wrong people. Because according to God, that land was rightfully for Israelites. But there were people dwelling in it, but God had purpose to give them that land, knowing there are people. That is why he begins to say, when the Lord your God gives you the possession, because it is God who will drive us to arrive to a place where we can possess what is rightfully ours. And it's also good to be able to see where you are going. Because when you go blindly, without focus, without expectation, then you may go with a multitude and you may miss the point. But immediately you identify exactly what you want to possess. I repeat again. When you understand and focus and see, this is what I want, then from step one, as you move towards to possess, you'll be seeing where you are going and what you are going to get. Somebody say amen. Because faith is by seeing and obeying. Because you match according to the word of God, not what exactly what you have. Praise the name of the Lord. We have a number of people today who are not here because, can you conclude? Come on, talk to me. Because it is what? A giving day. Is it by force? No. Because they don't know where they are going. They just look at their level and accept the deception of the enemy, who does not want them to prosper. Because when we talk about giving towards God, it's an opportunity. It's what? An opportunity. And those who know it, they seek for it. They say, I need to have an opportunity so that I can enter and access what is rightfully mine. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Ask your neighbor, are you sure you have nothing to inherit? What are they saying? Because until we bury you, or you bury me, there is still a place to inherit. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And so that is why you should not sit and wait. You have to stand up and begin walking and running and rushing towards your possession. It may not be easy because there are obstacles, as there has been always to those who have been ahead of us. But he never stopped them from accessing what God had said it was rightfully theirs. There are those who did not arrive there, although they were carrying the promises and the covenant, because they received a negative report. A negative what? Report. Negative reports will be there all the time, whether you like it or not. Negative reports will be there. And when you receive negative report, it depends on you where you are going. Because they were told the land was preoccupied and the people, they were might and powerful and all that and all that. And instead of saying, but God said, they began to cry. Tell your neighbor, be careful about negative reports. Many people innocently, they fail because of associating with the wrong people. With the wrong what? People. If you associate with somebody who is going nowhere, who is a negative talker all the time, you are perishing with that person. I refuse to be one of those people. Praise the name of the Lord. Why? Because what I want to possess maybe is not B wants to possess and not what C wants to possess. Praise the name of the Lord. But here the destination was one, to go to possess the land. And God was the one to enable them to possess it. Tell your neighbor, it is while with God is when you can possess. Tell them again. Tell them again. But Mulao, we have so many wicked people who look like they have everything in life. What you have not discovered is their end. Is their what? Their end. The son of Asaph, sons of Asaph said, I envied them. When I say they are wicked, they don't even pay tithes. They don't even come to the house of God. And they are blessed. I look like I'm serving a poor God. But he says, until I came to the house of God, when it was revealed to me, their end. Praise the name of the Lord. I say praise the name of the Lord. The durable and blessed possession is that which God gives. Not that is obtained through dubious things, through magendo, through stealing, through doing everything in demonic ways, in the influence of getting money and wealth. That has a very short cut and short life. The durable health, durable blessings, durable wealth, it is that comes from the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. I want just to remove your eyes from the worldly people, because on how they achieve what they have is only them who knows. Praise the name of the Lord. I say praise the name of the Lord. Possessing. Tell your neighbor, possessing. Possess your wife. Hata kama una utakuwa nayo. Possess your husband. If you don't possess, they can get lost. Umeelewa hiyo? Umeelewa hiyo? Your future, what you will become in the future, is only God who can make you that. Praise the name of the Lord. And you must have total dependence on him, that wherever I am going, I am not going alone. In the process and in the way of getting to get what belongs to you, there are many enemies who might look great, but greater is he that is with you than he that is hindering you. Praise the name of the Lord. Some of you have given up in life. You are saying, this is my way of life. I will die like this. I say, no, that is you. But God wants you to say what he says about you. Praise the name of the Lord. If he says I'll bless you, he will. If he says I will heal your family, I will save your children, I will save your husband, I will save your wife, I will make sure that your business does prevail. Praise the name of the Lord. What he says, it is what I say. Because he does not lie. Praise the name of the Lord. And that gives me strength all the time. And that gives me to be courageous, that I don't fear anything. Because when God is with you, nothing can stand before you and prevail. Praise the name of the Lord. Things will try to stand, but your God is like a bulldozer. He will crush everything to powder that you may gain the way. Praise the name of the Lord. I say praise the name of the Lord. You don't have to be discouraged in anything. So long as you have God. This is what I'm saying. Because in every blessing there is a condition. There is what? Condition to be met. Give us verse 1. Please do it quickly. Verse 1, not point number 1. Verse 1. When the Lord your God brings you into the land which you go to possess, and has cast out many nations before you. Now, who is giving these people the land? Who is casting the nations before them? But who will to do the fighting? The people. Say the people. Hallelujah. Don't sit down and say, Pas Mungu fanya kitu. He does not fanya kitu. Anasababisha kufanya kitu. Praise the name of the Lord. Because as many as he was talking to that time, thousands and hundreds of thousands of them, they never accept that place. Because they did not follow the conditions, which is faith, to believe that where we are going, it is going to happen exactly what God told us through his servant Moses. Many are the hearers, but few are the doers. Few are the what? Doers. People hear many things, but they do very little. They do very little. He will cast out many nations before you. In our case today, he will cast out all those who oppose you. They are very many. Sugar diabetes, high blood pressure, asthmatic, epileptic, short-sighted, slow thinking, and many, many other nations which are occupying what we need to possess because it is rightfully ours. Tell your neighbor, sicknesses are not part of your inheritance. Even you, my viewer, sicknesses are not part of your inheritance so long as you are a child of God. Praise the name of the Lord. They might come, but God will need to cast them out from you so that you can inherit the person that God created, the person that Jesus came to reconcile back to his God. Hallelujah. But we have accepted the way of life of the worldliness, and we are about to be getting deeper to the world system. Then our faith is no longer applicable in our ways. Hallelujah. In the world, somebody say, in the world system, abortion is a right. Am I right? Abortion is what? A right. Because it is the human right . Human rights means you can do what you think is right to you, but not what God has given you. If it's right, a human right, is it godly right? Is it godly right? But we are people today, born again, leaders, preachers, who can abort the child that they don't want because they needed only three, and the fourth one is coming. Yes, that silent means that tomorrow you will come to repent, or you're repenting now. Praise the name of the Lord. It is happening. Even parents, when their daughters are conceiving in the school, they take them to remove the life. They kill the life of that baby so that the girl can continue with schooling. Siazae na akuja endelee na shule. Ukitoa itakuwa jaza. You are not talking to me. Ukitoa hiyo mimba ya mtoto wako itakuwa jaza. Itakuwa meza na pia wewe umeua. You are a murderer. Are you with me? But it is done through human rights, which no, is not a God's right, because human rights are not God's rights. Human rights are contrary to God's right. So we are talking about inheriting, possessing what is rightfully yours according to the word of God. Somebody say amen. We must be different. The Bible says here that the seven nations greater and high, and mightier than you. Go to the second reading. What does it say? And when the Lord your God delivers them over to you, you shall conquer them and utterly destroy them. Full stop. You shall conquer them and utterly destroy what? Them. What does that mean? It shall be permanent what the Lord has done to me. It shall be permanent. You conquer. You possess. You inherit. You inhabit. Now listen to this. You shall make no covenant with them, nor show mercy to them. Ngojea hapo. What covenant means is that you compromise with what God calls sin. Praise the name of the Lord. When you do that and you make a covenant with them and you show mercy on them, show mercy. Kuonea huruma. Kuonea nini? Huruma. Mtu anakuja analia. Oh, ninakupenda, ninakupenda, ninakupenda. Anajifanya anaenda kwa choo. Anakuja amejipaka mate huko. Oh, ninalia. No, unaanza kulia, basi kuja. Basi kuja. Machozi yake ni mate, yako ni ya ujinga. Amuonea huruma. Hata huko huruma wafanyi hivyo. Are you getting me, church? Are you getting me, church? Why is God telling these people like that? Because they are peculiar people, chosen people, anointed people, people of destiny. Praise the name of the Lord. When you discover that you are a person of destiny, you don't behave like another person. It doesn't matter. Other than a billionaire, man, a trillionaire. When they are not in line with the will of God, let them be separate. Praise the name of the Lord. Let us hold fast the profession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful. Ask your neighbor, why are you wavering? Him who says he will do ABC today to you is faithful. Is what? Faithful. Whatever he says, is able to accomplish, is able to fulfill. What he doesn't want us to do is wavering. Wavering is compromising. Going this way, going that way, and the wind blows this way, blows you that way, blows you that way, and then you are not grounded in any truth, in faith and by faith. Okay, let's go to point number 4. You can boldly enter knowing you are clean. Tumeonyeshwa we are clean through the blood of Jesus. You can boldly enter knowing you are clean and your request will be honored. Full stop. Because you are fighting on God's side. Asai nini? You can boldly enter knowing you are clean and your request will be honored because you are fighting on God's side. You have a right to claim is what? In the Son's name and authority. Philippians 2, 9 to 11. We should enter boldly when we are possessing. Therefore, God also has highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name. In the name of Jesus, all things are possible. Okay, let's continue. That at the name of Jesus, every knee shall do what? Should do what? Bow. Those in heaven and of those on earth and of those under the earth. My God, tell your neighbor that problem must bow. It has knees. Iyo shida yako ina magoti. Mwambie hivyo. Your problem has knees and it has to bow. Hallelujah. Every knee shall bow. Every knee of every problem, every sickness, every what? Poverty. All that you are suffering from, that thing has a knee and it should bow. Whether it is your message held somewhere in heaven, whether it is on earth and even under the earth, all those things must bow. Tell your neighbor they must bow. Point number 5. All this giving us the authority and power to possess what is rightfully ours. And that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Hallelujah. Which verse is that? Have we done all? Okay. Therefore, you have a right to claim in the name of Jesus what you need. You will need also to be armed with authority of the word, the sword of the spirit. Ephesians 6, 16 to 18. It says this. Should I go there? Above all, taking the shield of faith with which you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one. What will you take? What will you take? The shield of what? Faith. It is what that shields you from the darts, fiery darts of the devil, and you quench them, all of them. And even from the wicked one, no dust, no uchawi, no nini, utatupiwa ikufikie kwa sababu umefunikwa na utukufu wa Mungu. Next verse. Quickly, quickly, quickly. Above all, taking the shield of faith with which you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one. Verse 17. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the spirit, which is the word of God. That word is what will tell the devil, this is my right, this is what is promised of mine, this is what I'm going to possess, and you are not going to hinder me from getting there. Verse 18. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, being watchful to this end with all perseverance and application of all the and the supplication of all the saints. Praise the name of the Lord. So as we possess, we must understand the weapon that is the sword of the Spirit. Ile silaha ya Roho Mtakatifu ni neno la Mungu. Ndio anachukua kupiga adui zako. Praise the name of the Lord. And this can only be done when we are able to pray. Because prayer is something very, very important when it comes to possessing. You are right. And prayers, nobody will pray until you plan to. Unless you plan to pray, you will never pray until Jesus comes. There must be a plan, your personal plan to pray. Hata ile ya kesho imefanya kupangwa kila Monday ni mpaka tuwe hapa tuombe. If it was not planned, hakungekuwa na Jumatatu maombi. So therefore, unless you plan also yours, especially in the morning, because it's found by those who seek him early in the morning. Praise the name of the Lord. When everything is silent, when the wind is not blowing here and there, and when demons are not there to engage you. So in Ephesians. Okay. Point number 5. You will need, I think we have read this one. Point number 6. You will need also to be armed with the authority of the word, the sword of the Spirit. I think we have read that. Remember, God has placed Satan and all what he has under your feet. Do you believe that? Say, under my feet. Again. Under my feet. So do not just sit and wait for something to happen. Full stop. Stand. Put your feet down. Make no covenant. Usikubaliane na giza. Show no mercy to the kingdom of darkness. Take the victory in Jesus' name. Luke 10, 18 to 20. And he said to them, I saw Satan fall like a lightning from heaven. Behold, I give you authority. I give you what? Will you stand on that authority? Will you? I give you authority to tremble. To tremble means the devil is under your? Are you getting me? He's under your what? Feet. To tremble on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. My God, what a wonderful promise from the mouth of Jesus himself. They have come from the mission and they come excited how demons were fleeing, how people were getting healed. And Jesus is telling them, while you were doing that, I saw enemy reiterating by coming down to resist what you were doing. Okay, the next verse. Nevertheless, you don't rejoice in this, that the spirits are subject to you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in the book of heaven. As we fight this battle, we must be sure that our names are recorded in the book of life, apart from recording in the book of the church. Jesus saw them rejoicing. We also rejoice when we see people getting delivered, When we see people getting saved, we are excited. But Jesus said, don't be excited just because of that. Hide that. You are excited because your name is recorded in the book of life. And this is where many are succumbing. When you begin to stand on miracles, sometimes you forget that your name should be written in the book of life, and you begin to compromise, you begin to covenant with the evil one. And that is how and why Jesus said, many will say, I preached, I casted out demons, but I will say to them, I never knew you. Because you can only know me if my name is recorded in the book of life. Praise the name of the Lord. He can only know you if your name is recorded in the book of life. Somebody say amen. Rise up on your feet. My viewer, wherever you are, you have heard this word from me. And God has spoken to you. I am sure he has. Because he speaks to his people. And I preach a God who speaks to his people. And I know he has spoken to you. So if you are not born again, and you are sure you are not born again, do not hesitate to give your life to Jesus. And if that is the desire and the cry of your heart, I want you to close your eyes, lift both of your hands, and pray this prayer after me. After that, I will pray for your needs right now. Pray this prayer. Say, Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. And today, I've heard your word. And I believed. And now, I stand here to confess all my sins. Forgive me and take away my name from the book of death. Write my name into the book of life. I will serve you and obey you in all the days of my life. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. Father, in the name of Jesus, I want to thank you for everyone who has given their lives to Jesus, here inside and outside there. Lord, I pray for God's blessing upon them, and that your glory and your power will overshadow them from the top to the bottom. And that, Lord, they shall be protected, and you shall cause them to forget about yesterday and to begin moving forward with the newness of life and the chapter that you have opened unto them. You have opened to each one of them a new chapter whereby you will start writing good deeds and good works. I bless you and I bless them. Those who are sick, I command healing upon their body. Those who have got broken families, I pray for the reconciliation of those families in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lost children and lost families, I'm calling them back home in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you. Bless Kenya, bless our president, bless his deputy and all the allies, and bless every the church in this country, and bless the people, and bless the Kenyan community. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. I said, my viewer, you want to communicate to us under your television. There are numbers rolling there. Pick one of them, call. Somebody will respond to you and you'll be helped. God bless you very much. I want to receive an offering now. And wherever you are, you did not make it to this service, you can pick up your phone and give your offering this morning. Take out a nice offering. Also, you can, if you need an help from our ushers, you need an envelope, please, you can put up your hand and they will come to you and they will give you what you need. You need an envelope for your use. There is a brown envelope with this multi-purpose. You can give it for youth conference, you can give it for building, you can give through that envelope. For any giving except the divine touch, we have a special envelope for it, which is white with red numbers. That is for divine touch. So whichever you need, you can ask. Lift that offering before the Lord. Lord, I thank you for the ministry of your word. I pray that, God, this word will not come back to you void, but dear Lord, you shall accomplish whichever, dear Lord, you send the word to do. Be glorified and be exalted, as you still help us to possess what is rightfully ours. I bless you and exhort you because of your goodness as you receive our offering this morning. Father, I thank you for providing, and that you shall rebuke the devourer. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.